So, we go further with the next speaker, Mr. Ralf Kliniotz. He is from the TU Chemnitz. He is research assistant of the research group Lightweight Construction Civil Engineering. And he talks about function integrative lightweight structures in civil engineering. Ah, here it is. So, the stage is yours. Okay.
Thank you very much. I hope you can hear me. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my presentation about function integrative lightweight structures in civil engineering. I will first give you a short instruction how we do with the lightweight. After this, I will talk about the method and the research focus of our research group. Then I will give you a presentation of two of selected references we did in the last time, and last but not least, a summary and small outlook. Okay, so why should we build energy and raw material efficient? As you see on the graphic, the need of the raw materials and like metals and fuels and minerals are increasing, and in the future it will not stop. So the lightweight construction is a global design concept, and we have the aim that with a significantly reducing the weight and the technical products and the components. So what's our intention? We want to save the weight. We want to make the dimensioning according to the loads. The material is there where we need it, and where we know need, where there's no need, we don't give there a place. Then we have a design based on the model of the nature, and then we got the functional integration. And all of this together will give us a high performance material and structures and technologies as well. So this is our research group. Our research group is called Lightweight Construction and Civil Engineering. Also, we do the lightweight materials, these lightweight structures. We develop the lightweight technologies, and we have the integrated functionality, but will I say some words later. Okay, when we talk about our lightweight, we have the three bases. One of them is the lightweight materials, the second is the lightweight structure, and the third is the lightweight system. The lightweight materials are there for that the reduction of the lightweight and the high performance materials give a good ratio of specific weight to strength and elongation and stiffness on the material. Lightweight structures means there's a minimum of dead weight of the structure and maintaining the mechanical requirements. Also, the design, number, and positioning of components give a minimum of the weight too. And the third one, the lightweight system. There we have, in addition to load-bearing functions, other functions as lightning, thermal insulation, or monitoring. These are combined in the component, and the multifunctional components is the result. All three together give us the resource and energy-efficient lightweight construction. That means we have the material development with the technological implementation, and we have the design, calculation, and optimization, and the functionalization in the multi-functionality. So our research group has the complete process from the idea to the referent object. That means when we get an idea, we start with the development, then comes the design and calculation and the validation, and then we have the demonstrator. Here we can show how the mold construction technology exists and the functionalization and the assembly of the work. And altogether is then the implementation of the work. So let's come to our first reference object. It's the honeycomb bridge made from GFRP. Our intention and our targets are that we use the fiber reinforced polymers because they have the ideal lightweight materials. Their properties are they have a high specific strength and stiffness, they are corrosion resistant, and they have a high durability. And they have a free-forming integration of functions. So you can see on the two pictures, there is one is the GFRP bridge, made of pultrusion profiles. It's in Denmark. And the second one is a GFRP bridge in Klettau in Germany, made by Fiberline Composites. These will give us give a better maintenance cost ratio, and the bridge structure can can achieve years up to 60 years. And when you compare it with a normal bridge, then you have maintenance costs on the conventional bridge structure in 100 years that will amount from 60 to 90% of the new of the construction cost. So we want to use the fiber reinforced polymers in the construction, and the method is not fully exploited at the moment. So here we see how the honeycomb bridge is built off. You can see the honeycomb core. It's from GFRP as well as the outer top layer and the inner bottom layer. And the construction is implemented of a new support structure and sandwich design, and we are inspired by the natural honeycombs from bees. Here we see the bees and their nest, how they build it, and as well, a little bit bigger, we did it with a bridge. So now, here's the experimental validation. The validation of the simulation of the sandwich structure is based on the bending tests on the honeycomb modules. One module is 2.5 meters long and 1 meter in the wide. And dimensioning are also for food bridges, and the dimensional load is 7.5 kilonewton per square meter. Maybe you see now the video where the experimental braking and the load of 144.5 kilonewton. But I think there's nothing happening. Okay. Now here we can see the CAD of the honeycomb bridge. You have the big arch, what is not from composite, but it is from steel. It has a span width from 30 meters, and the arch is 33 meters at the span. And the height of the arch is 13 meters. Now you see the GFRP flooring. The modular construction is from the GFRP honeycomb, what I told you in the last slide. And it is built up of 13 modules. These 13 modules have a total area of 80 square meter and a total weight of about 4 tons. Now you can see at our reference object at night. It is built in built up in Chemnitz, and you see the river Chemnitz. And also here is at night you can see the lightning. And the lightning is also reflected from the river too, and so it's a very impressive picture. So let's come to our next reference object. It's our biofacade. The objects were that we want to use the heat insulated facade system for a modern architecture, and it's for production buildings used with lower 90 degrees. We want to use the free-forming. We want to use the integrated interactive illumination, like the honeycomb bridge, and we want to use the renewable resources in the main focus. Now you can see how the bio-based facade element is constructed. You see that we have two face sheets. One face sheet is for the inside of the building. Then we have the cardboard core with stacked cardboard elements. And Then you can see the LED stripes with the cable ducts from the cardboard. And these face sheets on the, from the front side is translucent, so the light can go through. And then I will show you how it sees, how you can see. Before we can use it in the practical reference, we need to make a characterization. And all the characterization is regarding to the construction physics and mechanical characteristics. So the face sheets is natural fiber reinforced polymer. That means we have a flex woven fabric and a bio-based epoxy resin. And it has a lower strength and stiffness compared to GFRP, but sufficient for load bearing are as good as the facade elements needs to be. Then we have the cardboard core, where we can say that the shear modulus from 7 gigapascal is nearly higher than the PUR foam with a 5 gigapascal. So the dimensioning was made that the maximum deformation is about 6 millimeters by own weight, temperature, and stress in summer and winter. So we, it meets the deflection limitation requirements for the structures with high demands. So you can see the illumination. The illumination is our function integration. So with the other cable channel in the stuck cardboard with LED stripes, and they give the light through the single elements of the cardboard structure. And every structure is made like a little point of light, and so every point can be individually controllable, like a display or a screen. Here you see our facade element at the reference facade in the production hall at Richter and Hess in Chemnitz. It consists of 25 elements on an area of 10 meter long and 5 meter high. We only need two different half-sided elements. They are accordedly built up, and then so we need only two different tools for the production. I will give you a short introduction about what the assessment of the resource efficiency and sustainability is. The most important is that we have the whole facade element 70% of the biobase ratio and 30% as a less energy consumption if you compare it with the aluminium pure element. Now here is a small video about our facade system. And this facade can change the light, as you can see here. And it's not only for light as well, but you can also give up texts and pictures with a low resolution. So the architecture of the future requires lightweight construction. So new materials are required, new manufacturing technologies as well, and the result is the new automated lightweight construction. So you can say the construction meets mechanical engineering. This picture I didn't translate because it is an Anerkennung from the Sächsische Staatspreis für Spaukultur 2019, and where we got the pleasure for the, and the honor. Okay, so let me close with the words from Albert Einstein. The important thing is not to stop questioning. So, do you have questions?
So, yeah, thank you for the presentation. What's very interesting. Any questions to Mr. Gliniotz? Yeah.
Again. Question. Thank you very much for this very interesting presentation regarding the bridge. What kind of glass fibers have you used for this bridge construction? Was that a new glass fiber or was it a recycled one?
It was a new glass fiber, and this was endless fiber, okay. Yes.
But can you have you proven the possibility to use recycling fibers for that purpose?
Not at that, this time, because when we used it, the recycled fibers was not so much developed, and we need the requirements from the market, And so they were tested, and then the tested materials we can use was not the recycled one.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Another questions? Maybe I have a question. Yeah. You talked about, or I see it on a slide, the point fire protection. How is it for the bridge construction, for example, or also for the facades? Do you fulfill requirements?
We did fireproofment.
Okay.
The fireproofment were at the B1. It is burnable, mm-hmm. But you need a high power input of the flame, as well as the honeycomb bridge, as well as the biobase facade. It is burning a little bit, but if the fire stops, the burning stops too, and it's only a little bit smoking, and then it's all right for the use of the outside of the...
Okay, for a facade you could use it. Okay, good. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.